And hello YouTube, today at powerjackrepair.org we got an MSI MS-17F3 Creator 17M A9SD-U46US, something like that. The camera is too far away to pick up whatever is here, but maybe you're gonna be able to look through. Now the client states that the power connector is faulty. We got 1,000+ videos on this channel of different laptop makes and models that we do for the power jack repair. The jack is right here. We plug in our plug. It's not that loose. Let's see. And my voltmeter doesn't work. Let me grab another voltmeter. All right, so this one we're gonna set aside. We'll figure it out. Some of you would say, dude, why are you using such a cheap voltmeters? I have plenty of really expensive ones. It's just for this purpose, I prefer to use this one analog because it's not gonna damage the board in any way. So that's a ground right there. It provides really small voltage. It's only like a volt and a half. Well, hard to say. Well, the plus right there. The plus does not conduct anything. Seems like the plus, well, it conducts, but depends how well you wiggle it. All right, so this one I need to look into. Let's put that right here. Why this guy doesn't work? All right, but I mean, I got the, you know, those kind of voltmeters. But again, they wouldn't show me exactly what I need to see. All right, so let's set this aside. Let's find a... The good thing about this laptop is that nobody was playing around with it before, because there is a factory seal. Usually by the time we get the laptop, about 10-20 other people with fingers would put their fingers in there. And yeah, so that's really good. This is a really good candidate for working after the repair. So let's see. Please, before you're going to ship anything to us, make sure to check our website. Make sure there are notes that say that nobody is on vacation. Make sure the address is correct, because who knows. I mean, some of our videos are over 8-9 years old. And the location changes sometimes. Sometimes the people come and go. So here. All right. Again, the reason I show you all that, so that if you want, you could send us the whole laptop. If you want, you could send us just the motherboard. So we're trying to show everything as clear as possible so that you would know what to do in case you want to get the motherboard out safely, so that we wouldn't have to refund the money in case you mess up the motherboard while taking it apart, or mess up the computer, or break some hinges. So it's easier for us to show you how to do it properly than for you to try and take it apart without any guidance. So here's what I'm doing. I got this guitar pick, and I'm kind of shoving it all over the place, and I'm trying to separate the bottom cover. Here there was a crack right here already. I didn't just make it. Just sometimes people are accusing me of stuff that I haven't done. So here, and it's really hard to do any sort of customer support. Customer support is probably the biggest thing, the worst part of this business. Because when a client is unhappy about something, well, we always refund the money, but we always have to listen to why they're not happy. Alright, so that's the guy. The reason this guy breaks all the time, let me disconnect the battery first before I'm gonna do anything else. And the battery is probably glued. Oh my god. Yeah, it's glued to the casing, but we still need to remove it because it covers part of the motherboard. And the problem here is when you're trying to remove this battery, it sometimes could get cracked on the inside. So there is no good safe way to remove the battery here. All right, this is, if you're gonna start to heat it, this whole thing gonna melt. All right, You have to do some sort of due diligence, try and kind of pry on it from all the sides. Let's see. Yeah, it's all glued in there. Come on. You don't want to break the cells on this thing. First thing, you want to disconnect the battery, but in this case, you can't really disconnect it well, because it's easier if you disconnect it when the battery is out. I have to find something else. How about this guy right here? Let's get this knife. All right, like that. Let's see if we can get... Oh, you know what? I forgot. Hold on one second. I was thinking, why is the image like that here? Like that. Much, much better. All right. So... here, let's see. Come on. Doesn't want to come out. Yeah, the worst part is to deal with the glue. I mean, anybody who is an electronics repair... will tell you this is like, especially if you want to remove like a screen that's glued to the casing. Okay, so like that. Okay, so this thing, so that's a one cell right here, you can see it being like that. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to shove something here so it wouldn't be gluing back while I'm working on the rest of the stuff. Yeah, this is a way MSI does business. I mean, one time use laptop. Come on, come on. Come on. All right, so let me put this guy right there. And maybe... you know what? Comment below if you are able to get this guy out of there some other way, because, I mean, this is as far as my expertise goes. Let's try this guy. Right there. Come on. Okay, so here we got no more glue. Alright. So most of the glue is right there someplace. Okay. Come on. I promise you, this is the hardest part of the whole repair, right here. Because you don't want to break the whole thing. And yeah, maybe we can just do something like that. Come on, come on, come on. Let's shove this guy in there. As you can see, I'm doing everything possible not to break the battery here in any way, shape, or form. But sometimes it's really not possible. All right. I mean, you can't heat up the top side. You can't heat up the bottom side. You can't really do anything here. It's just extremely good design by MSI. I've been to Walmart yesterday. I looked at those prices. I was like, why is this MSI cost so much? I mean, why would anybody buy an MSI laptop for such a huge price? There was a Samsung there for three times less. And I was like, who in their right mind? Oh, I see right here. Okay. All right, yeah, so this guy is still kind of connected. Okay, let me get this guy out. So yeah, the problem here is that the glue here. There is a sticker of some sort which the glue is stuck to. Alright. So we better off trying to get this guy out right here. This is painful to watch, probably. Right? Yeah, it's painful for me to work on this too. Oh, now we can disconnect this guy. Alright, we are able to get it out this here. We just need to... Oh, no, we're not able to. It's all the same sticker. It's not so much the battery, it's some sort of sticker being stuck. Okay, so sticker right there. Let's see if we can just do a sticker here as well. You know what, hold on. Let's put this guy right there. Okay, like that. Finally. Alright, hopefully the battery is undamaged. It's a 3-cell, 1, 2, 3 cells right here. And that's the sticker that's basically you got this guy right here and that guy right there holding the battery down. Hopefully the battery is gonna be okay. The way you know how the battery is gonna be okay, if it's not warming up, it should be fine. Alright, good job. What a pain, huh? And this time I could have fixed a couple of motherboards already. Alrighty, so let's continue. Sorry, people are calling all the time, even though we mentioned it's better if you just text us, email us, because we always make videos. I mean, we built the whole YouTube studio just so that we could be making videos for you. So that's a text message, okay. Alright, so here, you want to disconnect this guy. Okay, do I want to, yeah, I probably want to remove this guy. I'm not sure if you have a video of this kind of laptop from before. Looks relatively new system to me. I mean, this is 2021, so who knows. Okay. I wonder if I could just put this cable through. Right, you see how it's guided like that? You need to remember how it's guided, because you don't want the casing to be jamming on top of the this cable, and you don't want to pull on that cable either. It's probably will not be able to find that cable if it gets broken anywhere in the United States, and from China shipping nowadays takes forever. Okay. Nope. You know what, hold on. Okay. Yeah, like that. Okay, let's see if
this screw is a through screw.
Let's see. Now you don't want to use this thing to screw in all the way. Simply because does not say extremely sensitive right there. So just a little bit. Let's see. Again, I'm not sure if I need to remove the heatsink. If I don't have to remove the heatsink, that would be awesome. Because a whole bunch of stuff usually can go bad, go wrong if you remove the heatsink. But I think I have to remove it because I see it's not coming out. Doesn't seem like, yeah, there's a screw right under the heatsink right there. So I have to remove everything here. All right, here like that. Like that. Like that. Okay, let's see if we can remove it safely, because what you want to do is you want to raise it slightly upwards. When you're raising it upwards, the pads under the heatsink, they remain in place. And you don't want those pads to be messing up all over the place. There should be pads here, 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 there. We will see right now. Let's see if there are pads or if there is a rubberized, well, siliconized, not rubberized, silicon. Okay, let's see. Come on. Come on, come up. Come this way. You don't want to bend anything here. The whole board comes up. All right, so like that. This is going to be on top. All right, so here is the situation which I didn't want to happen. There is one pad like that. And this pad's supposed to be there. You see how the pads are aligned? So that's your position. Make sure your pads are going to be exactly the same way here. And I probably need to remove every single one of those pads because they're going to fall off while I'm trying to solder anything here. Or maybe they're not going to fall off. Let me see what I can do here. Let me remove all of the dust that's accumulated there. Right there. And right there. Okay. So we want to unscrew this screw right here. I so don't want to touch those pads. They're sitting so beautifully in there. Let me clean up the GPU and the heatsink. When you're cleaning this thing up, you just want to clean the top side. Don't try to clean the sides. All right, like that. All right, don't touch anything else. Just make sure just to clean the top. On this thing, you can also probably clean the sides as well, but extremely careful. Sometimes this this dust from the silicone gets onto the connections like here. So make sure there is not too much dust from the silicone because the system might not work. There is some sort of metal shaving right there for some reason, strange. Shouldn't be any metal shavings in there. All right, so once this screen is clean, we still have connections here. And I want to clean the CPU and the GPU heatsink. Alrighty, so I'm sorry, I don't have enough funds to buy another 4K camera to show you how I'm cleaning up the heatsink over a garbage can. But just Q-tips, basically. Alright. Here, let's see. We want to flip this guy over right here. Like that. So we flip this guy over. Hinge like that. This guy right here. Wow, the board scratches easily. This board is like an Apple board, same thing. It doesn't conduct, it doesn't heat up well, so. All right. Here, you see that the jack looks fine, right? The jack looks fine, but usually what happens is this piece right here, where it connects to the pin, to the center pin, it breaks right here, right at the connection. And that's the reason. I will show it to you once I take this apart. I'm sure that this piece is going to come separate from this guy, even though this should be all be the same piece. So visually, you would not be able to say if this thing is broken or not until you're going to remove the whole thing. So once you remove the whole thing, you would be able to say if this thing is broken or not. What I want to do next, I will probably cover it with the no lint cover like that. And we're going to use the ESD safe tape. Check it plenty of. Alright, so we're just going to use the ESD safe tape like that. And like that. And let's try. What I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to keep all of those pads in place so they won't fall off. I don't want to remove them and transfer them to the heatsink, because it's just an unnecessary step and they might not be as perfectly aligned as I want them to be. Alright, so here. Alright, so electrostatically safe tape. ESD gloves, so I'm never even touching your motherboard with my fat fingers, so to speak. Trying to gain weight, but so much stress can never gain any weight. If you want to lose weight, just keep stressing. All right. Let's see. My best advice in life: you want to lose weight, just stress all the time. Okay. So here we got just a few components there in the back. Nothing really to be worried about. Let's use some thermal tape. You could use Kapton tape here. The links for those tapes, for the Kapton tape and this tape right here, it's just a foil, but that foil tapes to the motherboard. This is a energy saving product. Well, it's a high temperature tape, like 600 degree Fahrenheit or something. Can withstand the heat up to 600. And what I'm doing is I'm just making sure that all of the components that are nearby, they're not gonna fly off the motherboard when I'm done with this repair. All right. Now, so what else I'm gonna be using here is the Kapton tape. Even though I used to use Kapton tape exclusively for many years, now I'm starting to use this tape because we do a lot of micro soldering, and when it comes to the micro soldering, this tape is, you can't live without this tape, because on micro soldering there's so many microscopic components nearby you can't even see them, so you have to use this tape right here. Not the tape, but well, tape. Yeah, so here what we're gonna do is this, like that, like that. Okay, good job. Now I think this thing gonna melt. So what I want to do is I want to just remove it. Well, it's not removable, but it's going to melt and stink. It's going to stink so bad that you don't want to be anywhere near the computer when this thing is going to be stinking. Okay. All right. Good job. So just remove it somewhat so that it wouldn't be in a way. Now, can you remove this guy just with the soldering iron? Yes, you can. I have a whole bunch of videos from like 5, 6, 6, 7, 8 years ago when we didn't use the hot air, but then I realized that just by using hot air, I'm simplifying my life tenfold, and all I have to do, I just have to prepare the motherboard like that, and it's gonna be alright. So, the next step here is to add some flux. Add some, not the silver base solder, but a leaded base solder to the connections. The leaded base solder gonna mix with this unleaded base solder. Use some hot air. It's gonna drop the jack from the motherboard. Clean up the holes with the soldering wick. And then find the jack like that. I know I have every single jack there is that was made in the last 25 years for any of the computers out there. So if you can't find this jack, the link should be below, but sometimes I keep forgetting to update the website for where we sell the parts from. So if you can't find it there, just point it to this video and say, you know what, I need this jack, and I will be able to find it for you. So let's take it all apart, basically again, flux and a solder, and clean up and put a new jack. Alrighty, so now we are at the soldering chamber, It seems like I'm sitting quite low here. Hold on, let me raise up myself. Alrighty, so that's the jack right here. Make sure it's nice and flat on the surface. Put some support underneath it. All right, this guy is a bit sharp here. I don't see where is the secure pad here. Hold on. It's really easy to cut yourself here. All right, so like that. And let's put some flux. The link to which fluxes we use at the audio is messed up here because there is a huge exhaust fan that's blowing, and I'm trying to minimize the effect so you wouldn't hear it. So the audio cuts off a lot. I just don't want you to get any headache here. All right, so we are putting some solder on the iron. Then we're putting a whole bunch of solder right here. And you can see that it sticks. All right, okay. But not as good as I want it to be because the board is not preheated. No, that's not working out for me. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're just gonna put this iron behind air station. And I want it to blow away from myself because all of the chemicals. All right, so we're just gonna preheat it a little bit. I just put it on the lowest setting, on the lowest heating setting, on the... Oh, shoot, everything blows this way. All right, let's reposition the camera. Let's reposition the hot air. All right, you're probably gonna be getting vibrations in the picture. All right, so you see how much better the solder flows into the motherboard. All right, like that, and like that. Good job. All right, wonderful. All right, good. All right, let's see what it looks like on the other side. All right, so here what we want to do is we also want to add some solder right here. All right, and we want to get some solder right there. Okay, some solder right here in the back. Alrighty, clients keep texting all the time. Good thing they're not calling so that I would be able to finish this video. All right, so here. Now, I should probably increase the hot air temperature. The flow remains the same, lowest flow, so that components won't be damaged nearby. All right. All right. All right, it just, this board is cool. I mean, it just dissipates the heat like crazy. So you probably have to put it onto the maximum heat. It needs to have, I mean, I don't see how you can desolder it with just the soldering iron because this board is really, huge thermal heatsink. Right, as you can see right there, this guy is already separate, yeah. You see, this is not supposed to be happening. Alright, so what we have here is just this guy, that guy, and this guy right here. Okay. Alright. Good. Mission impossible, guys. This is mission impossible. I didn't expect it would be so bad. Alright, so let's crank up it all the way. I have a whole bunch of modes here in terms of how high the heat gonna go. But this is the maximum there is. Well, not yet. I mean, I still have a little bit more left. But I just didn't wanna put more heat into it than needed. Yeah, this is extremely huge heatsink. Come on. No, it can't be like that. I mean, it should be already out. Be out. Okay, come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on. Alright, now we just have the rears to deal with. Alright. Okay, it should follow by itself right there, you see? Okay, so now we reduce the heat to simmer, and now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the where is my soldering wick? All right, we're gonna take the soldering wick and desolder all of the guys right here. Alright, good job. Okay. Okay, good job. Let's flip it over. Let's clean up here a little bit on that last one. Like that. Alrighty. Looks good to me. Now we're gonna remove the... was that flowing like that the whole time? Alright, let's see. Alrighty. So... this is exactly the same jack, same manufacturer, and you see the pin right there is connected, so that's how why everything should be working fine, because that pin is attached properly. We're just gonna put some flux right here, and then we're just gonna connect this right here, and let's connect it right there. Okay. Let's pick some flux on this end. Okay. And alrighty. Pretty good job. Looks good to me. Okay. And let's solder it here. Alright, so here what I did was just making sure that the ground is gonna be shorted right there, you see? So once it's all shorted, the ground itself is gonna be alright. So here we're just gonna use some ISP to clean this baby up. Alright, let's do a good cleanup right here. Alright, so I did clean up a little bit here, and it seems like the solder didn't get soldered well right there. Alright, so now it's all good. Alright. Alright, sorry about the vibrations. I put the 4K camera here, but it picks up all the vibrations, all the minuscule vibrations from the exhaust, from the hot air. So, here, let's remove that. All right, let's do it like that. All right. So it's gonna dry out while I'm putting it all back together, and then I'm gonna test it to make sure everything's gonna work. But that's pretty much all you have to do to make this guy. And that jack is kind of unique jack, so if you need to buy exactly the same replacement, you want to buy it from the website below. Oh, was it recording while I... Uh-huh. Okay, so sorry about that. Anyways, I was thinking I would probably have to... Again, I'm not sure what I was talking there about, but let's see. Okay, let's see if we're just gonna rip this guy apart. This is a no-lint kimchi wipes. It's not... Kimtech, not kimchi here. Kimtech wipes. Alright. And all of the pads are in place. Alright. I just want to double check that there is no shortages on the motherboard. Let's try and see. Alright. Okay. Okay, so we're gonna put this wire through right here and close it down. Okay, we're gonna put this wire through right there. And close it down right here. And I should have another wire, which is that's the hardest wire to connect. All right, let's see. I'm not sure if I told you this already, but probably not. It's probably a good idea to watch it on a big screen TV, so you could see everything I'm doing here, like that. Okay, so this one gonna go on top and then under and into here. Okay, those three guys are connected. This guy we're gonna connect right here. All right, and yeah. And let's see. All righty, let's continue working on this thing because had to fix a few other things while the people were... Alright, so this is not it. Okay, this is separate. Okay, this is this guy right here. Alright, I already forgot what I was doing here. Sometimes I have a hard time remembering, did I replace the jack already? Is that a new one or is that a used one? I am sure this is the one that's brand new right there, I can see that. Alright, plus I can see when I was recording this. How long the recording already been going on. So, yeah, so the whole business model is basically replacing the jacks day in and day out for the last 20 plus years. Unfortunately, I lost all of my employees in 2019-2020. And I can't hire anybody in 2021 for obvious reasons, because there is shortage of employees. I mean, McDonald's pays $50 an hour to work at McDonald's. I can make more money working at McDonald's now. You know what? This is a bright idea. You know, what am I doing here? So yeah. Just in case you go to the website and it shows that I'm on vacation, I'm probably on vacation working at McDonald's or Chipotle's. I think you can make $100,000 a year working at Chipotle's now, after 3 years. That's what, it's the same company, it's the same McDonald's. The largest property management company in the world. Mm-hmm. But they say they sell the burgers on the side, just it's like a dividend. All right, yeah, I think we have to put one screw right here. And I think we need to put We need to put some thermal paste right here, right there. And that would be probably it. So let's get some thermal paste. Let's take different gloves. Let's put different. Alright, so the gloves are on. Where is the thermal paste? Alrighty, so we got thermal paste. Let's unscrew the thermal paste. All right. Make sure the pads here are properly aligned. Let's get some dust off of here. Okay, so this guy is connected. And we're just gonna drop it down like that. Does it sit properly like that, or it's not sitting properly? Looks like it sits properly. And here sits properly as well. Okay, let's change the gloves because my arms are sweating in those gloves. Let's see, do we have too much glare here, or do we are okay? It looks like we are okay, right? Let's maybe add more light. Well, yeah, like that. Better? Yeah, more light is better. All right, so and one. Right there, and two right here, and three right there. And four and five. Okay, I would rather leave it like that. Let's put some tape right where the old tape was at. All right, so there is one. And here is two. Like that. All right, and this is gonna be fine. All right, let's use the regular screwdriver to screw in the heatsink like that. Like that. Like that. Yep, we got one more screw going in right here. Alrighty. Looks good. Alright, so we wanna put some tape right here on top of those two cables. Alright, so you see this sticker is where it getting stuck to that sticker keeps holding everything really well. Alright, so what I wanna do first is well, let me just double check one more time. Yeah, everything's screwed in. So I think that way or that way, I don't think it makes much difference. Alright, so the battery is connected. We're gonna drop it here, like that, and like that. Let's, beautiful design in terms of the wiring. Just like, let's run a wire from this end to that end, and it's gonna sit right on top of the motherboard. Yeah, why not? Beautiful, yeah. So how are we gonna secure the battery to the casing? Well, this is $1,000 laptop, so let's just put some glue. Maybe we're gonna use some screws. Nah, why would we wanna do that? No, let's make it as cheap as possible. Well, one other thing is maybe okay, like that, like that. All right. Okay, good job. Excellent. Excellent. All right. Looks good to me. Now let's close this thing down, and hopefully it's gonna work. Now let's see where we have the most amount of need to get it from this end. Okay. So you see we got two holes right here. And the problem with those holes is that the casing needs to be kind of like that. And like that. All right. Everything would be nice and easy if this would not be glued together. Alright. So here let's screw down the screws. Okay. Okay. Okay, the problem is I don't have the power supply from the client. It's 9.32 amps. No wonder the jack didn't work for such a long time. Yeah. I mean, when I see something close to 10 amps, you can 200 watts. No jack out there gonna be able to handle so much power. Look at this dragon. Wow. Oh, wow. Creator 17M. You know what? I need to look for one of those on eBay. Maybe somebody's selling with the broken jack. Maybe I would be Creator too. It is i7 9th generation GeForce. GTX NVIDIA card. Cooler Boost 5. Do you know what that is? I don't know either. And learn more. High resolution audio. It's probably that cable. No, Finn Bezel. No, really. It's Finn Bezel and the screen is really expensive. This is one of the best screens in my opinion because it's a matte screen. Matte screens are usually more expensive than the Ultralight. Well, I don't know about the ultralight. I think it's kind of, this is probably not about this. And it's a creator center. Well, I don't know. Creator center or not. I was able to finally find the power supply that's powerful enough to power up the system. It takes me much more time than to fix the laptop. It takes me a lot more time to find the power supply. This is from Toshiba. 19 volts, 9.5 amps right there. Exactly what this laptop needs. And it has a slight modification right here, exactly for the plug that this laptop needs. So a lot of modifications. You plug it in. Do we get any lights indicating that something is charging? By the way, this guy is plugged in or not plugged in. Is there a light indicating that it's... No, there's no light on the brick itself. Well, oh, okay, so we got the light right here on the side. Yeah, let me show you. No, I'm not gonna call it super light because the brick itself is waiting like right there. You see the light? All right, I see the light. And let's press the power button. And we got the lights on the keyboard. Let's shut down the auxiliary lighting here so you could see everything. And you should have a dragon right there. All right, so we got the dragon. And now we're gonna wait a little bit to see if you're gonna have an icon right here on the bottom right-hand corner. Don't wanna show the client information in case it's gonna come up. Okay, so, all right. And right there, so we don't have a client information right here anymore. Right here, you see? It's a 4K camera, so you should see right there that it's charging, you see? All right. Thanks so much, guys, for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe. I will let you know which laptop models I would spend my money on and which ones I wouldn't. Everything is working fine right here. And I will charge up the battery and ship it back to the client. I want to test to make sure the wireless card picks up. Oops. If the wireless card picks up. All right. And the wireless card. Yeah, the wireless card picks up. All right. Wonderful. And the keyboard should work. Oops, wrong presses. Okay. Anyways, so it's all good. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Leave a like and have a good day. Thanks.